Are you concerned about Japan's nuclear facilities melting down and that radiation going into the environment? Because you should be. And I'll explain it to you in a way you're probably never going to hear from mainstream media. Several days ago, I put out a video just before the earthquake about depleted uranium and the isotopes from the depleted uranium. Now, the isotopes are the same kind of isotopes that are coming out of Japan's reactors. And when they released pressure several days ago from some of those reactors, there was plumes of smoke. There was one radioactive plant exploded, but they say it was contained. And they've tested several thousand people in that area with gamma ray detecting devices. Also, you got to take it into consideration what the lifespan of this radiation is. It's around 4 billion years. So by releasing that into the environment, those isotopes, and there's no isotope so small it won't give you cancer. And just because you're on the other side of the Pacific Ocean, don't mean in 20 years you might not die of cancer from the isotope from that. Because it's like a slow kill. If you're close to it, you're getting a massive insanity amount of radiation, and that might kill you within hours, within days. There's 160 that they're claiming is poisoned. They evacuated 140,000 from that area. They got a 6-mile exclusion zone around it now where they evacuated everything. And what I'm trying to do to you is to point you what radiation actually is. It's got a 4 billion year lifespan, and it floats around the world for the next 4 million years, and any human, mammal, fish, water, anything that it gets into is contaminated for 4 billion years. So say it gets into a worm in the ground, it goes into the ground and the worm gets radiated, and a bird eats that worm. Now the bird is radiated and he digested that isotope. Now when a bird dies, that isotope will eventually liberate itself and float around for another 4 billion years looking for a host. Think of something that never goes away, is here until the very end of time, killing. That's the isotopes that are coming out of that reactor and came out of Chernobyl and is coming out of the depleted uranium munitions being used in conflicts worldwide for the last couple of decades. The link below, I have all the clips in it of the experts on radiation, on the isotopes, on depleted uranium, which is releasing the same isotopes as the nuclear reactors. People are saying, oh, it's blown out to the ocean. This stuff is going into the environment for 4 billion years. Yes, for a few days or a few weeks we avoided the isotopes, but they don't go away, and you can't just go out and pick them up. These are sub-micron sizes, smaller than a bacteria. So you need an extremely special face mask to even attempt to filter that out. So you see all these Japanese people testing people for radiation exposure wearing these white dust masks. They're absolutely useless. So those people who are testing other people to see if they're radiated will come in contact and themselves will find themselves dying of cancer over the next short period, or at least within 20 years, almost all of these people will be dead because they came in contact with the isotopes and the dust from this radioactive particle that kills for 4 billion years. Now, a Dixie cup of this stuff, if you put it in a restaurant, will kill everybody in that restaurant within the hour, and will continue to do that for the next 4 billion years every hour. So if you took all the bodies at a restaurant and filled it up with 200 more people, come in an hour later, they're all dead. You can do that for 4 billion years. That's how absolutely devastating these isotopes are. There's no way to contain them. There's no way to get rid of them. There's no way to clean them up. There's no way to filter them out. There's no way to stop them from radiating everything they touch. So if that lands in the water, it's going to contaminate that water for 4 billion years. If it lands in farmer fields, if it lands in anything, it's contaminating it for 4 billion years. This stuff is so toxic and so dangerous that absolutely nobody is immune to it. Nothing is immune to it. That's what this radiation is. Like I say, I got the link below to a 35-minute video I made where I included all the clips. And that's why I'm putting this video out there, to point you to that video so you can actually thoroughly understand 100% what these isotopes actually mean to humanity and to life on Earth. You've got to realize, folks, the entire planet at this moment is gone ballistic because these nuclear facilities are melting down and the radiation that is being leaked into the environment. I got clips of the specialist here in the link below, and they will tell you just to deplete the uranium, we have released 250,000 Nagasaki bombs, atomicity equivalent radiation isotopes, into the environment just from depleted uranium bombs, bullets, mortars, shells. This stuff is the exact same as what's coming out of Japan. So hopefully this can raise that awareness also of, here we are, have we got a Hiroshima worth of nuclear waste being released into the environment, excuse me, over the next several days and the last few days. Compare it to 250,000 Nagasaki bombs worth of depleted uranium isotopes released into the environment in conflicts through the illegal use of depleted uranium. Once again, I got the video, I'll put the link below, it's 35 minutes long, and I have all the clips of the experts in that. And if you truly care, if you're a media source, if you're a news source, if you live in that area, if you have family, friends, and just want to inform yourself, that clip is invaluable. That 35-minute video in the link below, that will explain to you why this stuff is absolutely a catastrophic event, not only in Japan, but worldwide, but also you need to know the rest of that information. That's why you have to go and watch that 35-minute clip and be informed and share that information. And the links in that video, of the link below, there's links underneath that to all the original footage that I used to explain it. My heart goes out to all the victims, past, present, and over the next decades from this radioactive fallout that's coming out of Japan. It's absolute tragedy beyond imagination what happened in Japan. It's tsunami, the earthquake, and now to have this is just, it's a death blow for humankind, you know. Anyway, best wishes you and your loved ones.